Next topic, federal government's planned $22.8 billion loan. The federal government on Tuesday last week sought the approval of the Senate for concessionary external borrowing of $22.8 billion for development of infrastructure across the country. Minister of Finance and National Planning Zainab Ahmed made the presentation on behalf of the federal government when she appeared before Senate Committee on Local and Foreign Debts. Mrs. Ahmed said the loan sought for was segmented into 7 concessionary loans from multilateral institutions. She also said the loan, which was part of the 2016 to 2018 external borrowing plan, was designed to enhance productivity of the economy via development of roads, railway lines, electricity projects, agriculture, among other sectors. She went on and on, you know, to talk about how we are in good standing when it comes to our debt profile and all of that. But then social media users are not having this because they seem to think the government of the day is borrowing too much. Akobun, what do you say?
At every level, we're all into kleptomaniacs who have decided that our commonwealth is their family treasure. Mm. And it's rather unfortunate that nobody is looking down. It's less than 20 years ago that Obasanjo got out of debt that he put us in, actually, mm-hmm. in 1977. Mm-hmm. And now we've tripled the debt that he took us out of. Mm-hmm. It's rather, of course, they have just cause to claim they are using it on infrastructure. Mm. But we all know that they took the Shakushi Fund for infrastructure, they took the IMF loan for infrastructure, they went to the Nexim
Fund, yes,
for infrastructure. Right now, I think we have about 14 individual, not easily explained loans that we've taken that our grandchildren will have to pay for mm-hmm. one way or the other.
All right, Chief of Force, how do you react?
Just recently, when Buhari came to power, I think we actually exhausted our Paris club fund in paying salary. They will bring the gift to this governor, we'll go on a party spree, mm-hmm. we'll go on holidays and everything, and again we'll go back to borrowing again. I mean, if President Muhammadu Buhari, according to his campaign in 2014, I follow it religiously on TV, he said that Nigerians, what he's going to do for Nigeria, is going to live a very better Nigerian life we have never seen before. And I think with all of this borrowing, I don't think he's going to fulfill that promise. It's becoming too much. Another thing is that if the one that we have borrowed, we have seen what we have done with it, then we could just be quiet and say, he's trying. He's actually doing a lot with the money that he's borrowing. But we are not seeing it. Every time we go borrowing, there is another deal that we even have to go with China that even involve a currency swap. Mm-hmm. I don't know what happened to that deal by now at this point, because China is supposed to invade this country, constructing, making Nigeria one big construction site.
They're starting with the railway lines.
I must see what is happening. Mm-hmm. So if you are keep borrowing, it's just like maybe tomorrow now we'll start
for the same infrastructure.
I will start going to Akogun mm-hmm. and Peter and look for money mm-hmm. so that when I get the loan, mm-hmm. I will go partying somewhere and everything. So I think at the end of the day, the federal government is not doing themselves any good, apart from putting all of us in trouble. Because mm-hmm. someone would not say, Oga, maybe you guys are owing me too much. I need some part of your country so that I can use to recoup my loan. Maybe that will happen someday.
All right, Mr. Sangbe. Let me quickly put this out there. Now, the Minister of Finance earlier said Nigeria has is a revenue problem and not a debt problem. Now, if we do have a revenue problem, that means we're not generating as much income as a country as we should. Then how do we service the loan
that's a problem, and that is why the government strategy ought to have been based on ability to generate revenue.
Okay.
And I think that was one of the reasons they gave.
To ask father to roll.
And all. Mm-hmm. You see, my worry is not really borrowing. You know why? Because most countries borrow. Mm-hmm. My worry is in borrowing to do what? What is going to be the outcome of this borrowing? Mm-hmm. If you say infrastructure, if I recently it was said that most countries do not have confidence in Nigeria. Nigerian leadership, not Buhari as a person, mm-hmm. but our track record in terms of managing funds.
Okay.
And that is why those who are returning their batch out want to sign an agreement with you.
They are returning it with a warning.
Yeah, yes, they provide so that this is used for this.
Is it not last week that even US has threatened that they will not even release again?
Isn't that a slap on our face, you know, like...
No, it's not.
It's our money. You get what I mean? It's our money.
So they don't want you to reloot the...
I get that. Okay.
So what I will expect, you know, because yes, it is taking Buhari now, who has, so to speak, integrity to do all this. But Buhari cannot be everywhere. Do you understand?
I do.
And there's this accusation of graft, you know, against some persons in his government.
Mm-hmm.
So he's not really monitoring them well. Mm. So my worry is that we're most likely going to go back to where we were before, you know, where monies were borrowed, they were not used for the purposes, just as can be seen in the way that government. Some previous governors are being jailed now or are being prosecuted.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you check the list, they say the Paris Club, whatever reformed, the money was embezzled. Whatever it was, all the loans and everything, you know, were not used for the purpose. They were used for personal purposes.
For what, 35 projects?
Yes. So the question is, what is the strategy being put in place by this government to ensure that this money that you're going to borrow will be used for the purposes?
I think the original purpose was basically to stimulate the economy.
Okay.
You know, by providing jobs to infrastructure renewal. We've not really renewed our infrastructure in about 40 years across the board. Whether you're talking about electricity, you're talking about roads, talking about rail. And we all need to cost a lot of money. But we agree with the government in the beginning because we assume that the integrity will win.
Yeah.
And that we'll be able to use the money judiciously.
Akogo.
But you and I know 5 years down the line. That's not the case.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Akogo, you can see all of this is not just about foreign loan alone. If you look at domestic loan, how can you explain that last year, that just about a month to the election in Kogi State, the federal government is giving a loan of 10 billion naira to a state? Is that state, that state governor is actually standing in that election?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, no serious country in the world will look at you and say, I want to give you loan. Look, that's why we are getting loan at an interest rate that is so ridiculous.
Mm.
Because they know you need the money, but because you say you are going to pay. And at the end of the day, the problem, like Peter said, the problem is not just with the former governors being jailed. I think the former president should also be jailed. So that we can show as a deterrent, when you get there, you should... Nobody says
be accountable.
What I'm also saying is that look, there is no president, there is no governor in this country that stay on his salary, that stay on his allowances, that can be broke forever.
Okay.